All right, joining us on Hot Copy, MMDA Chairman Francis Tolentino. Good day to you, Chairman. Thank you so much.
Morning.
Now, let's start first with the Boston blasts. How that must be a security nightmare here in the Philippines. You are in charge of securing all public events. I mean, here we have something that's very tight, which is the Feast of the Nazarene. We also have marathons here. We have Ironman in the Philippines. Now, you've seen what happened in the U.S.
Yes. First, we can only commiserate with the plight of the victims as well as pray for the quick recovery of the other 132 plus victims. But I just came to realize that I've been giving out permits for marathons, fun runs, left and right. So there's probably a need to revisit some of our rules,
yeah,
not just for purposes of traffic management, but to include the Philippine National Police.
How does one secure a place like that? I mean, any event like that. I mean, you can imagine Boston Marathon would be so strict. The city would be strict.
Mm-hmm.
What's involved?
For hundreds and perhaps intelligence gathering would be part, lots of CCTV, but for a determined, we don't know yet the root cause of this, for a determined bomber, ang hirap siguro.
Oo.
Right now, we're having a Le Tour Filipinas,
okay,
bicycle race,
yes,
about to reach Metro Manila. So I think pag-aralan sigurong mabuti yung scenarios, implications for sporting events.
Uh-oh. Now, there's a saying, actually, it's a quote after 9/11, that no country can really protect itself, mm-hmm, from terrorist attacks. Do you think it's true?
I agree.
You agree?
Yes.
Okay, because any amount of, yes, security, why do you say you agree?
It's now an open, borderless environment. You don't have the former notion of policemen securing an area. Boston is supposed to be secured. Last year, we sent a contingent to the Tokyo Marathon. It's a different scenario there, but I think there has to be a greater collaboration between the participants, the organizers, and the police, similar to what they've done in during the London Olympics. But this one is different. I think we have to let the investigators finish their job first.
Yeah, yeah. But if a country cannot ever be safe, what do we do?
Safety and security should be a personal concern.
Okay. Concern.
Yes,
okay.
You don't just let society take over your personal safety concerns, not just let the police, the community, but it has to be a per household, per person, security focus.
Mm-mm. Okay. Now, moving on locally. I mean, we do have campaign security to speak of.
Mm-hmm. That's the reason why we filed this petition before the Commission on Elections, asking them to ban certain events using our thoroughfares, because, mm-hmm, we've been we've been handling permits for fun runs, marathons, and other sporting events. But for motorcades, we came to realize that there's also a need to regulate the use of thoroughfares during the political season.
I agree, and it's troublesome on EDSA.
That's why COMELEC issued COMELEC Resolution 99666,
okay,
banning certain motorcades and caravans in 22 major thoroughfares.
Okay, all caravans,
motorcades. Yes.
Anything? I mean, that with noise.
No.
Okay, running slowly.
To define a motorcade.
Okay,
would
what's
mean
a motorcade?
The use of two or more vehicles,
okay,
espousing the candidacy of a candidate or a political party.
Okay.
A barker would not be included in that definition.
Ah, pwede ang barker?
Yes,
oh
yes,
my
yes.
God, I hate those.
So,
yung pwede, when you say barker, eto yung isang sasakyan.
Yes.
Boto nyo si ganon,
yes,
maingay
yes,
sa
yes,
EDSA.
Yes,
okay,
yes.
Yon.
So, with this COMELEC resolution, it's no longer just a mere traffic violation. It now becomes an election offense.
Okay.
So if it's an election offense, it's punishable by imprisonment, not less than 1 year, not more than 6 years.
Or disqualification.
Disqualification. Disqualification is part. Plus you can also be deprived of your right to vote.
Yeah. Now, but why were not barkers included? They contribute to noise pollution, ah? And I mean, some people laugh about noise pollution, but it's serious.
It probably can be covered by existing ordinances or the civil code concerning nuisance when it annoys the senses.
Yeah. Yeah,
so, but it's a different matter.
Okay.
What we're after is to minimize congestion during the campaign period for Metro Manila only.
Okay, can you read the thoroughfares where the motorcades are banned?
22 thoroughfares, okay, to include EDSA, C5, Quezon Avenue, Marcos.
Can you make it slow? EDSA, C5.
Yes, C5, Quezon Avenue, all the major thoroughfares, 22. But there are certain exclusions.
One is
you can cross.
You
can cross EDSA, for instance, to reach another congressional district.
But that's a bad excuse, okay? Right?
Or to briefly reach a U-turn slot. That's an exemption.
Okay.
Or to reach a non-major thoroughfare, which is not part of the COMELEC resolution.
Yeah, but is a motorcade allowed in Makati, for example?
For the secondary streets. So the rule,
but not Ayala.
No.
Okay.
Not even Ortigas. So the rule right now is it's banned, but for the secondary streets, you get a clearance, a permit from the local government unit notifying the MMDA 3 days in advance.
Okay.
So we created a special office, an ad hoc office for this sa amin fina-file ngayon yun sa mga motorcades.
But how are you able to actually watch over everything? I mean, the MMDA is in charge of so many things.
If it's really a big motorcade, we deploy some personnel. We utilize our CCTV.
Yeah.
And it's on a first come first serve basis. If there is a previous application, even if it is not acted upon by the local government unit, after 3 days, considered approved.
Yeah.
So we can deny the succeeding applications for the same date, for the same place.
Okay. Now with the buses, just to clarify, The yellow bus lane still stays.
Yes.
They should not be on the flyover, or are there certain buses that can actually be on the flyover?
There are certain flyovers that can be utilized. Magallanes, okay, Ortigas, and one more.
Uh-oh. Because the buses really cause traffic.
I agree.
Uh-oh.
That's why we're into the integrated bus terminal. We hope to have the first one by June of this year.
Now, is there a plan to actually slowly wean off buses? I mean, from EDSA? Because, Chairman, when you look at these buses, most of them are empty.
That's LTFRB's role. But,
do you coordinate? How does that go?
Yes, but for the provincial buses, we hope to have the first bus terminal operating by June.
Okay.
Hopefully. Mm-mm. So, I have here the
okay,
sound,
go
sound
ahead.
The plans.
Can I see?
So, this would
this is good news.
Yes.
Can we show it? Okay, what is this, Chairman? This is
for the Southwest bus terminal.
For Southwest.
This would involve the Cavite, Batangas buses.
Oh, okay. Where will this be exactly?
Near Coastal Road.
By June tapos na to?
Yes.
Wow, bravo. Okay,
hopefully,
can you describe?
Hopefully.
Wait, baka naman pag bumisita ako doon, lupa pa lang to.
Malapit na.
What do you mean, hindi pa
malapit
ginagawa?
Malapit lang matapos.
Malapit lang matapos. Can you describe this terminal? How many buses? Okay, describe it.
So more or less, we will reduce provincial buses entering EDSA by a little bit less than 1,000.
Oy, very good.
So they would just be disembarking passengers
okay.
in this integrated bus terminal.
Can you shoot this direct? Let's show this. Here's my finger. Here.
Yes.
Okay.
One. So this is supposed to be the passengers' lounge.
No. Here. This one. Down. Okay. So this,
lounge.
Okay. Can you describe this? These would be the provincial buses.
It's coming from Cavite and Batangas.
Okay,
so
and then they would drop the passengers here.
And then first come, first serve.
The passengers would be here.
Yes, and they will be picked up in the same place by the city buses.
By the city buses.
Yes. If your destination is Fairview, Cubao, Pasay, Makati, dyan na lang dadaan yung city buses.
Oo. So, ang galing ah. So, ang tanong ko lang, Chair, yung provincial buses na ito, who will be dito ibababa itong mga, will they lose income?
No.
No?
No.
Same rate? Same fare?
Actually, for the first 6 months, libre yan eh.
Ah, libre?
And right now, they're paying an X amount for some people utilizing secondary roads, which is not supposed to be the case.
Meaning yung mga provincial buses, yes, they're yes. paying.
Yes.
Oh my
they're
God.
They're paying barkers.
Kotong?
Yes, they're paying... hindi ko na pamanggitin.
So, maybe mayors.
Mawawala yon, dito na lang sila.
Dito na lang?
Yes.
Okay, so you've spoken to the owners of provincial buses and are they happy
they
about it?
They have signed an agreement with me. Tapos na yon. So I think I will still need 3 or more sessions with them.
Okay.
And this place is now being refurbished. So hopefully by June.
Hopefully by June.
Yes.
Okay, wag ka na hopefully, dapat by June.
By June.
Baka maging NAIA Terminal 1 po ito, ha? Yung NAIA Terminal 1. Tatlong taon na po ang Pangulong Aquino. It's not even yet renovated.
Malapit na ho ito.
Malapit na ito. Now, what about this? Can you describe this?
That's a toll booth. The passengers can secure tickets using a centralized system. And that the ticket can be utilized kahit saan bus.
Oh, how very modern.
So no need to
kahit saan bus to Metro Manila?
No, to the provinces.
To the provinces.
Yes. So yung conductor no need to carry yung mga change, loose change. So menos hold up and everything.
Oo.
So parang airport. Now
usually coming from coastal, who would be the passengers? Would they be the types working in Manila every day?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Going to Baclaran, the students going to the University Belt area. So this is also the same area where the LRT extension would pass.
Uh-oh.
So after this, pag nagawa rin yung LRT, it would be an intermodal environment. Nandiyan yung AUV, nandiyan yung city bus, nandiyan yung LRT.
Now would this cut traffic? Even for the passengers,
we will be able to reclaim some of the side streets of Rojas Boulevard.
Wow.
Na ginagawang parking lot ngayon.
Sino gumagawang parking lot?
Yung provincial buses, no?
Oo.
Yes, so magagamit na natin yung side street after Baclaran Church.
Oo.
Side streets after Heritage.
Yeah, good news. Mm. Now, if you catch a provincial bus that is still in Metro Manila na wala nang permit,
they would be out of line.
Okay.
So they can be considered as colorum. And then the colorum buses would not be able to utilize this. Ang papasok lang dito yung legitimate buses with franchises. So yung colorum,
okay.
Cavite and Batangas colorum buses would no longer be able to enter Metro Manila. Mm-mm.
Now how many buses are we talking about that's registered or licensed to actually use this terminal?
For this, our exact figure would be 892.
Oh, 892?
892.
And others are colorum?
Siguro, kasi wala sa 800. So if it's going to be 1,500, yung sobra, that's colorum na.
Oh my gosh!
So maalis na yun.
Okay, alright. We're gonna take a quick break. When we return, we'll continue our discussion with MMDA Chairman Francis Tolentino. Hot coffee, we'll be right back.